say thank you to my top listeners from this year.
Spotify rep.
Spotify informs me that I am in the top 1% of Harry Styles listeners.
Every year, sometime in December, Spotify delivers this campaign to all their 500 million users across the world that tells them all about their passion for music and what they've been listening to on Spotify over the last year. Everyone gets this really unique compilation of their top songs, artists, genres, total number of minutes that they're actually spending listening to music on the app. It's one of the biggest marketing campaigns in the world, and it's definitely the one that's talked about most on social media and talked about again and again and again every year. In 2022, it was shared over 100 million times on social media. And historically, this campaign's actually led to increases in the number of customers using Spotify. In 2020, app downloads for Spotify actually went up 20% around the time that this campaign was launched. What a lot of people fail to realize is just how big of a data initiative it is to pull off a marketing campaign like Spotify Wrapped. First off, Spotify offers, you know, over 100 million different songs on the platform. That's not even counting their podcasts and audiobooks. There's this old Quora thread that I found with a former VP of engineering at Spotify that claims that Spotify at the time had between 150 to 200 petabytes of data. And that was in 2016. So you can imagine that the company has probably crossed into exabytes and exabytes of user data since then. Just one of the 500 million users streams over 2 hours a day of content, and that's close to 700 hours per year. So it's basically a ton and ton of information that you have to process and data infrastructure that you have to have in place to be able to produce a campaign like this. So all in all, it's a huge data initiative to make a campaign that's this personalized and this high scale. So this is all pretty cool, but how does Spotify Wrapped actually work behind the scenes? Well, there's basically a few essential components to the Spotify Wrapped campaign. First is data collection. Spotify has tons of consumers using their mobile app, web app, listening to Spotify on their TV. And what they need to do first is just collect events from all of these different mediums that people are listening to Spotify on about what songs they're listening, what are the genres of those songs, what are the artists, what are they saving into playlists, and all this sort of user information. Once that data is collected, it likely goes into a big central place like a data warehouse. Once it's in this central data warehouse, Spotify's data team is basically able to easily compute metrics on top of all their user data. So they can write SQL queries or build things like Tableau reports that compute things like what are the top artists that every single user across our 500 million users listened to over the last year, or what are the top genres. And lastly, there's sort of an activation or personalization problem. So once Spotify's created these insights about what their customers are listening to, those insights need to be activated or delivered to Spotify users inside of email campaigns, the mobile app of Spotify, and the web app, and all these different places. So the final question, the million-dollar question, is what makes Spotify Wrapped as a campaign so successful? And how can you emulate it in your business? So if I were to sum everything up, I think there's really like three aspects of the campaign that make it really successful. First, it's highly, highly personalized. The campaign has these metrics that are super cool that describe your usage, and they're like extremely personalized down to a user level. A lot of companies are running marketing campaigns and that are personalized, for example, showing you items that you might be interested in at a store or showing you new releases in a certain category that you follow. Spotify Wrapped is really personalized to a level that we haven't really seen in other marketing campaigns. The second thing is more just from like a marketing perspective, not even a data perspective. Spotify Wrapped creates this FOMO. Anyone not using Spotify can't really engage with it. Everyone's sharing it on their social media, and it immediately makes you want to start listening to music via Spotify instead of whatever other tool you're using, like YouTube or Apple Music, because you want to have Spotify Wrapped and be a part of the thing that's cool right now. The last thing I would say is that the campaign is really designed to go viral. And one of the big reasons it is so viral is because it's actually genuinely interesting for customers of Spotify and provides like actual value to the customers versus just selling them on something. So if you think of it from Spotify's viewpoint, the tremendous effort they're putting in to bring together all parts of the organization, from the data teams to the infrastructure teams collecting this data, to the marketing teams, to even the product teams, and delivering this awesome experience in the mobile app, is well worth it based on the fiscal impact of this marketing campaign. 10 years ago, it wasn't that easy to create a campaign like Spotify Wrapped. And today, I wouldn't say it's easier. It's super easy either, but it's way easier than it was because every company has access to modern data technologies like Snowflake, like Databricks, etc., and really has the ability to start building amazing campaigns like Spotify Wrapped if they put that data to work and are able to activate it across all the marketing, sales, product, etc. tools in their business. And that's exactly what we help with at High Touch.